A blessed morning to everyone. I hope that we are all doing well. For today's devotion, it's related about the end time. And ever since the pandemic began, a lot of people is asking, is it the end? Because of, you know, what's going on around the world. And if it is, my question for us this morning is, are you ready? Usually when we look forward to the end times, we look at events, signs, prophecy being fulfilled, the Israel, and etc. But there's one thing that we disregard always, and that is the people in the end time. Can we find description in the Bible of the people in the end times? And the answer is yes. There's a lot of passage about it. But for this devotion this morning, we'll focus in 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1 to 5. So our devotions, I entitled our devotion this morning, The End Game. And I know this is a famous term that is popularized in a famous movie, but later I will explain the meaning of the term end game. So 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1 to 5 tells us, but realize this, that in the last days, difficult times will come. This is Paul warning Timothy 2,000 years ago. And actually, this is applicable to us as well, because the long list of description by the Apostle Paul is actually can be seen in our age or generation today. The Bible tells us, but realize this, that in the last days, difficult times will come. In the end time, it will be difficult. In other translation, the word difficult is translated perilous, and this is used to describe the savage nature of two demon-possessed men in Matthew 8, verse 28. So in the end times, it will be a demonic time, okay? And there, in verses 2 to 5, are characteristics or personalities of people in the end times. And I can say these descriptions are demonic descriptions of the people. And what are those lists? Verse 2, for men will be lovers of selves, lovers of money, boastful, arrogant, revilers, disobedient to parents, ungrateful, unholy, unloving, irreconcilable, malicious gossips, without self-control, brutal, haters of good, treacherous, reckless, conceited, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, holding to a form of godliness, although they have denied its power, avoid such men as this. So, in the scripture, it tells us that we should avoid these worldly people. Just like in 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 14, it tells us, do not be mismatched with unbelievers. For what do righteousness and lawlessness share together? Or what does light have in common with darkness? That is literally mentioned in scripture. So if we have friends that is worldly, that has somehow relate, have this characteristic, we should avoid them. And also, though it's not written in our passage this morning, but it is implied, since these are description of the unbeliever in the end times, of course, as believer of Christ, we should not do this. We should, if ever we have this, we find this in ourselves, these characteristics that's mentioned in the Bible, then our approach should be, we should abolish this in our lifestyle. We should repent as soon as possible before it's too late. All right? So a while ago, I told us that I will explain the term end game. So in chess, the end game, that end game is a chess term. So if you're a player of chess, there is an opening, there's an opening game, middle game, and the end game. So, and in the end game, usually it involves sacrifice. So for a player to win, usually it involves sacrifice. That's why in the movie, the Avengers, the characters, sacrifice some of their friends for them to beat their enemy. So what is that how is that related in our devotion this morning? And that is my conclusion this morning. To overcome this perilous time and be victorious, we must sacrifice this worldly satisfaction by abolishing these characteristics within ourselves and avoiding this kind of people in our life. I hope that we can be victorious over this time. May God be with you. Thank you and God bless.